What's happening inside there could impact people all over the world. Think of this as a quarantine tent. People in here have been quarantined since the quake. Many of them have tuberculosis, which is why we're gonna wear a mask like this. You'll notice the door is open. If you stay about 10 feet away from someone with tuberculosis, you'd be okay. And sunlight kills the bacteria as well. But once we go inside, you have to wear a mask like this. Let's go meet some of the patients. London, New York, Atlanta, San Francisco. Do people need to be worried about what's happening in this tent?
Over time, this is going to grow and grow. If we allow TB to grow in Haiti, people are going to travel, people are going to be infected, even workers like us here. And that can really spread to Miami, New York City, and eventually to San Francisco and the Southeast. And we really do not wish to have multi-drug resistance. It's something that even in the U.S. we can't treat well.
All right, class, pull out those short stories I gave you yesterday. Hey, Jake, would you please read?
The Red Death had long devastated the country. No pestilence had ever been so fatal or so hideous. Blood was its avatar and its seal, the redness and the horror of blood. There were sharp pains and sudden dizziness, and then profuse bleeding at the pores with dissolution. The scarlet stains upon the body, and especially upon the face of the victim, were the pest ban which shut him out from the aid and sympathy of his fellow men.
Haiti has taught me that any pain I have ever experienced is nothing. Blue light streams through the thin nylon tents, creating both a false sense of calm and a stifling greenhouse heat upon the sweating bodies of those who had been infected with Haitian tuberculosis. Voodoo hoongans and Catholic priests walked among the groaning bodies, uttering prayers for protection and divine intervention. Many of those who could stand either went to church or voodoo ceremonies. Blood from slaughtered goats was sprinkled upon voodoo dancers. Their eyes rolled back in holy trance.
Did you sleep here?
Yeah. Can you please don't tell anyone that?
I might have to tell administration.
No, please, just this once.
But with the sickness going around, you know, you don't look so good, Carter.
I'll be fine, I just need to wash my face.
Well, go on, don't be late to class.
Okay.
No tomorrow, no tomorrow. And I find it kind of funny, I find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I've ever had. I find it hard to tell you, I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very mad world. Children waiting for the day they feel good. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Child should sit and listen, sit and listen. Went to school and I was very nervous. No one knew me, no one knew me. Hello teacher, tell me what's my lesson. Look right through me, look right through me.
I feel myself leaving. There is nothing but need left. A new set of instincts which overwhelm my being. Soon I will be gone forever. I no longer remember what it's like to feel happiness or comfort or satisfaction. The hunger for life. The battle has ended within me. Pain has destroyed humanity. The world has gone quiet.
RTB, retro tuberculosis, non-entrance. city of Boulder that has been quarantined by the United States federal government. Our prayers go out to anyone left in the city. God have mercy.
Looks abandoned.
I hope so. I don't know how much more blood I can take.
Here, you give me the bat, you keep the flashlight.
Whatever, man, it's your funeral.
Shut up. I have better eyes than you.
Well, we need somewhere safe to hide. Hopefully without windows.
I'll check the attic and you go in the basement.
Alright, man.
No zombie ever opened a hatch?
And the darkness and decay and the Red Death held illimitable dominion over all.